The Great War is on, but your computer is just a tad too old for the task. Alright. Well, this is still a very new release, I want to share some of the tweaks possible on this game so you can get started on blowing stuff up, even though you're under the minimum requirements. This is the LowSpecGamer, where minimum settings on menu are to be ignored, and commenters will complain that a 460 is a top-of-the-line GPU. So, forget about visual clarity and DirectX 11 effects, because we're making this game run. We're going to start with a resolution of 720, more about resolution options in a second, motion blur to the minimum, depth of field off, resolution scale to 60%, and all quality options to their lowest possible. As you can imagine, this does not do very well. At all. Ever. So, what else is there for us to do? Before we continue, I must warn you, in my experience, Battlefield 1 is a very CPU-intensive game, so make sure all background applications are closed, that the priority of the game isn't high, that your antivirus is on gaming mode if it has one, and still, with all of this, I'm not sure I will recommend this game unless you're confident on your CPU or comfortable with overclocking. Okay, the first thing that we're going to do is to open the configuration file for the game located in Documents, Battlefield 1, Settings, and the file is called Prof Safe Profile, which you can open with Notepad or Notepad++. In the bottom of the file, the GST render commands control graphical quality, and even with everything to the lowest, there's a couple of extra things to keep an eye on. I have noticed a measurable small increase in stability by dropping shader quality and shadow quality to zero, and even though the game has a minimum resolution of 1025x768, you can force a lower resolution by changing the height and width commands over here. You may want to hold off on that, because you also have a resolution scaler. Scaling internal resolution allows you to change the resolution and detail of the game while retaining a readable UI. In the settings screen, the lowest possible scale is 25%, but you can also control it via this line in the file where 1 is full resolution, 0.5 by 50%, and yes, if you're feeling adventurous, you can go under the 25% limit. Wow! Now, in order to tweak further, we need to experiment with console commands. You can open the game's console with the tilde key on the upper left corner of the keyboard, but putting commands there is only temporary. If you want commands to be run every time, you have two options. The first is to create a file where the game is installed. By default, this is on Program Files, Origin Games, Battlefield 1. And you need to create an User.cfg file here. Remember to enable viewing file extensions in your folder options so you can name the file correctly. Not a .txt file, a .cfg file. In the description, you will find a copy of the commands I use, the first one being an FPS meter, that you can also use to know if the file has been read correctly. These two disable some extra DirectX 11 effects. These three are commands that will make better use of the CPU, and you must change this 4 to the number of cores in your CPU. This will disable some effects that were still on even when everything is on low. If you want to play on windowed, these two commands can be used to control the size of the window. And everything down here is just to ensure everything else on the command list that can be disabled is disabled. One little problem though. On certain computers, the game will disable the user CFG when entering multiplayer mode. You will notice this if the FPS meter disappears when you enter a multiplayer map. There's a way to get commands to load in this case. In the description, you will find the same commands as launch parameters that you can add in the properties Advanced Launch Options of the game in Origin. Oof, that is a lot of instructions. Let's see how it goes. Come on, man, I just want to help you guys on the tank. Let me get in. Let me get in, alright? Yeah! Woo! Right on time. Right on cue. Alright! Time to be a motherfucking tank. Literally. Give me something to shoot at. And we are dead. Thank you very much. Where are they coming from? Plane. Yeah, because that's gonna do shit. Whoa, shit! Oh, I got him! I got him! Yes! Come on, get here. Come on, come on, come on, come on. He's not dead. He's not... dead. Seriously, I'm not going to rest until I bayonet someone. can be World War I without violating people. Wow, Jesus Christ, this is a mess. Let's ride the tank, boys. So that's one way of using a tank. We're gonna... That's okay. Everyone, behind the tank! Get him, get him, get him! Oh, f***! Whoa, whoa, this is insane! Wow! Next deployed... Did Dreadnought kill me? What the heck is that Dreadnought? Is it a ship? Under fire. I need to help my people. Oh, someone's taking A. Alright, let's go with that. Let's take A. Let's fuck him up! Oh, this is fantastic. I'm having a really good time. That's definitely a Dreadnought. They were not joking about that. Fucking hell. Oh, we're being fired. We are being fired all over the place. Oh boy. Whoa, 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 prone, prone, prone! Shh! I'm alive. Barely. I'm no longer alive. Shit. Retreat, retreat, retreat! Jesus fucking Christ! Whoa! That guy just got blown into pieces right in front of my eye. Whoa! Oh, they weren't kidding with the Dreadnought thing. Boy, this is... Okay, so next point. F. Okay, I died. That's fantastic! If I die from the mustard gas while trying to violate someone. That's the definition of World War I fantasy for you. Whoa! Fucking hell! Oh, the bloody... The Dreadnought moves. Okay. Point taken, the Dreadnought moves. Thank you very much, Doctor! That probably wasn't supposed to happen, but it happened, alright. I wonder how the... are the horses. Is this something that I can use? This is 100% something I can use. I don't know how to play like a horse. Oh, that's a sniper. Take it, take it, take it! Yeah! Eat my fucking horse! He is terrible at cutting people. Take it, fuck, fuck, no! Yeah, I see the machine gun, I see the machine gun, I got it, don't worry about it. We got this point, boys! Let's not lose it again. Oh god, we're getting blown into pieces. With this, it's a very hard to maintain position.
We are winning.
We are? Okay. Yep, I guess that's how it is. Yeah! We actually won! Fantastic. That is all for this video. Remember that if you want to check out the exclusive behind the scenes blogs of what is going on in the channel, you can donate just $1 in Patreon. Look at all these cool people already doing that. See you on the next video.
I have run out of electricity again.